Hey, what's up, guys and gals? It's the Tyrod here, and it's that time of the week again where I get to sit down with my favorite community members, that's you guys, and answer your questions. There's no real news this week that is really worth mentioning, so we're just going to go ahead and jump right into it. For those of you who don't know how this works, essentially, if you want your question featured in one of these Q&As, you just have to ask it in the comment section below. Now, understand, I only answer a few of them a week, usually 10 to 12, and from there, if... So your question may not be picked, but keep trying. And if you're really adamant about it, if for some reason I haven't picked yours in a couple of weeks, hit me up on Twitter, because I usually hold those at a slightly higher priority. It's not that they're more important, but usually if someone hits me up on Twitter, I assume it's because I've missed their question for several weeks in a row. You can do that at Mythic Tyrant. I'll go ahead and put a link right there on the screen for you. But if you're not following me on Twitter already, it's definitely a great way to communicate with me and also get to see all the banter between me and the other major Halo community players. So definitely check it out on there. We've had a lot of collaboration going on recently. We've got some big stuff coming up. So definitely check it out and follow me on Twitter. So our first question of the week comes from Andrew McCollum. And Andrew asks, will Halo 7 actually be the final chief Halo game as a tribute to Bungie's favorite number, which is 7? You know what? That's my favorite number, too. Yeah, to be honest with you, I don't think so. In fact, I don't even think there's really going to be a Halo 6. I think that there's going to be a sixth installment, which will technically be the 7th if you count Reach. But I think they're trying to lose the numbers, hence why there's a Guardians title in Halo 5. Like, I think that may be the transitioning phase. I have often said I think Halo 6 should actually be called Halo Reclamation and bring a close to the series. And that's what I'm hoping for. I can't see this being dragged out for two more games, to be honest with you. I think they're going to wrap up the Reclaimer saga in the next Halo game, or at least the next major title. So that's a great question, Andrew. Thank you. And by the way, for those of you who don't know, he asked that question on Twitter. So good job, Andrew. Thank you for following me, bro. Our next question comes from Mr. K. Did you ever work for Will Smith by any chance? And K asks, could we get a game about the insurrection? I hope not. Personally, Halo is a game, or to me at least, Halo is a game where you fight aliens. It's not a game where you fight people. There are already too many games out there like that. You've got Call of Duty, Battlefield, you know, everything like that. Halo does not need to turn into Call of Duty any more than it already has. So I say keep the insurrection out and keep it in external lore only. But it's an interesting question, and thanks for bringing it up, Kay, and have fun working with Jay. Our next question comes from Sergeant McMuffin. Uh-oh, there's a sausage out there with your name on it, bro. So McMuffin asks, not sure if you answered this, but anyways, during Halo 5, Locke and Chief fight, and they are portrayed as equal opponents. Do you think this is completely out of character for Chief? He's a Spartan 2 and emotionless walking destroyer class tank who had a tough time trying to fight someone half-ass ODST turned pseudo-Spartan. That's a mouthful, but it's a cool question. So, to be honest with you, I don't even know what's considered to be in character for the Master Chief at this point. Ever since Halo 4, he's gone in a completely different direction, even a few times in Halo 3. But to be honest with you, I've always thought of the Chief as this, as you said, emotionless guy. He's a soldier. He's been one since he was 6. It's hard to wrap my mind around him having too much emotion, even if it is his friend Cortana. I mean, hell, he knew most of his team all his life, or most of his life anyway. And you don't really see that reflection of his personality in the books. In short, I don't know how to classify his persona. It's not the same as it used to be. So maybe this is the new Chief. Maybe this is what we got to get used to. But if that's the case, maybe... And to play to your point of it was weird for him to lose, I also keep in mind that... Or like to keep in mind that Master Chief's sort of getting old at this point. And people like to factor in the cryo sleep, and he's not as old as you think he is. But he's, even if you take out the cryo sleep, he's still pretty up there. He's in his late 40s at least. So, even if you're not sure with that, look at the legendary ending for Halo 4. When you see his wrinkled old eyes and stuff, tired, if anything. So, I guess maybe this is the new him. Like it or not, that's what we got. But great question, Sergeant McMuffin. Thank you. Our next question comes from Hesitated Cobra, and Cobra asks, how long do you want Halo 6's campaign to be? As long as it needs to be. I know there are a lot of people out there who are a little uptight about campaign length. They say, oh, it's got to be real long, and let me tell you something. Over the last year, I've learned a lot about campaign length and what it really means to me. I played Gears of War 4. It was really the first Gears of War campaign I'd played all the way through, and it was long as fuck. I mean, don't get me wrong, the graphics were great, the acting was great, and the combat was fun, but it just wore you out way too quickly. It was just the same shit over and over again, and I clocked it at about 7.5 hours of record time. That's not even how long it took me to actually get used to the game. So, to me, that was way too long, way longer than it needed to be. On the other hand, I look at Titanfall 2. And that had a solid campaign from start to finish. Very original. It almost felt like Portal meets first-person shooter. I mean, I know some people consider Portal to be a first-person shooter. It's not, because you're not really killing stuff or shooting guns aside from the Portal gun. But it had a puzzle-esque tone to it, which was very unique for me for a first-person shooter. And it just the plot was fantastic. The characters were great. It was basically what I consider to be as close to a perfect campaign outside the Halo franchise as I've seen or played in a long time. And it was only about 3.5 hours long, 4 at most. To me, that was a far superior campaign than the one to Gears of War 4. So to me, campaign length doesn't matter. I've mentioned in previous videos that I'd like to see an opportunity to branch out in the campaign, to be able to choose your path, choose a different set of missions. To go on and make different choices so you can get different outcomes. I think that would be cool. It'd give it a lot more replay value, and you wouldn't necessarily have to drag out a single campaign in the process. If you wanted to go back and replay it and play it a different way, you have the option to do that. But if you just want to see the end game, then you have the option to do that too. So that's what I'm hoping for Halo 6. I hope that answers your question. It's a great one, and hopefully they'll actually listen to this one, Cobra, so thank you. Our next question comes from Austin K. And Austin asked, 343 said that they wanted to get away from having numbered Halo games, but do you think Halo 6 should be called Halo 6 since it's the last game in the Master Chief saga? In short, I sort of answered this one before. I would actually prefer them not do Halo 6. Just call it Halo Reclamation. The Halo 6 sounds kind of weird, and of course, if you do Halo 6, everyone's going to be expecting Halo 7. Rather than them trying to, you know, do something different with the series. So I hope they do not call it Halo 6. I think that's kind of a cheesy title. It's a title that doesn't really speak to me. And I hope they go with Halo Reclamation instead. So hopefully that answers your question, Austin, and thank you. Our next question comes from Jacob Wilcox. And Jacob asked, how would you feel if Bungie were to step back into Halo and maybe replace or take over 343 Industries? And do you think 343 Industries can bounce back from the fail of MCC, which is the Master Chief Collection, and launch of Halo 5? Thanks, Tyrant. Okay, so remember, Bungie is a company. That's it. You have to remember that it's the people you have to think about, and not everyone who worked at Bungie during the Halo days is still there. Marty O'Donnell, the guy who wrote the best fucking video game soundtrack of all time, is no longer there. A lot of people who worked at Bungie, or at least a handful of them, came over to 343 Industries. Bungie doesn't want to work with Halo anymore. They've been not wanting to work with Halo for a long time now, and Microsoft sort of, sort of pressured them into making the last two games, which weren't supposed to be made, as far as I know, at least. So, honestly, no, I don't think Bungie should get involved. I think that their time for Halo has come and gone. You can argue that maybe Halo should have died back when it was supposed to, and maybe not, you know, trying to milk it for everything it's worth. But at the same time, I think 343 is doing as good of a job as you're going to see any company do. Now, I'm not saying that it's perfect. It's not. I've had my fair criticisms of 343's games and how they do things. But I don't think it would be any better if you took Halo away from 343 today and gave it back to Bungie. If anything, I think it would be worse. I know that's hard to believe, but I've seen where Bungie's gone. I see where 343's heading, and that's the best call that I can make. So I hope that answers your question, Jacob, and thank you. Our next question comes from Cillian CB. Oh, that is a kick-ass name. And Cillian asks, should playable Arbiter return? You know, we've talked about the squad system before on this site, well, several times probably, and even in the Q&As. And what I had mentioned, and this pertains to your question, is that as long as all the characters are popular ones, that that could work out pretty well, so that not only you had three squad mates with you at all times, but these were characters that people liked. So, for example, I mentioned that Arbiter should be one of the characters, along with Buck and Locke. I know people are sort of iffy on Locke, but because he had such a big part in Halo 5, you kind of have to put him in Halo 6 or Halo Reclamation or whatever. And if you do that, you have the option of playing as Arbiter in co-op. I don't want to see them switching players around. It needs to stay chief focused, because they really screwed the pooch on that one in Halo 5, especially with how they tilted most of the game in Locke's favor, a character we had never seen before. And no, I'm not counting Nightfall. You know how I feel about external lore being counted as canon. So I think he should be playable, but only as a co-op character. And in that spirit, I'm hoping they bring the squad system back. I know some people don't like it, but personally, I thought it was an improvement to Halo. I don't throw any rotten fruit at me. And steak, you can throw steak at me. But in all seriousness, I think that's how it should be. Arbiter should be an optional character, not a mandatory one. So I hope that answers your question, Cillian. And again, kick-ass name, dude. And is that CB for the radio? Our next question comes from Mudkip454. And Mudkip asks, why do you think 343 has been avoiding dual wielding and playable elites? Is it true that they are racist against elites? Also, I want to dual wield energy swords. So if they're racist against elites, does that mean they're elitist? You know, here's the thing. I've talked about this. In fact, I just did a video yesterday about playable elites. They seem to be making a push towards making Halo 3 more relevant again. Even if they're not going to do a Halo 3 anniversary anytime in the near future, they're making Halo 3 backwards compatible for Xbox One and Xbox One X. They're bringing a Halo 3 playlist with both Halo 3 maps and Halo 3 gameplay to Halo 5 Guardians. I don't see playable elites being out of it completely. I don't see them being counted out. And part of the reason I think that is I see all the stuff from previous games that they brought into Halo 5. Think of the grenade launcher from Halo Reach. Think of the anti-air wraith from Halo 3. You know, they're doing that, and I can see them bringing elites back for at least custom games. I don't know if they would do that for multiplayer unless it was an invasion type of game or tournament, simply because there's too many balancing issues there. I think it's possible that they could bring them back, and I hope they do. In terms of dual wielding, I would love to see that brought back. I know some people think, oh, it's overpowered. No, it isn't. If you're a good player and you have the right weapons to counter it, it can be done. Do I think it will be? I don't know if it will be in Halo 5, even if it's in a future update, but it could be for the next major Halo title, and I'm hoping that it's at least revisited and brought back to the drawing board. Maybe it can work if it's done the right way. So that's an excellent question, Mudkip, and thanks for stopping by. Our next question comes from my boy Arcos Trevelyan, my fellow Trevelyan bro. And Arcos asks, dear Tyrant, aww, what are your thoughts upon adding the following vehicles to Halo 6 in addition to the usual lineup? The Grizzly Tank, the Hawk, and the Vulture. So he's talking, of course, about vehicles from Halo Wars, or the Halo Wars series. And personally, I would love to see vehicles, including the Grizzly, make it into the main series. In fact, if you've played Halo SPV3, Masters Leet, a good friend of mine, actually incorporated the Grizzly Tank into the game. So it's pretty cool. If you haven't checked that out yet, it's definitely worth your time. Do I think they should bring it into Halo? I don't see why not. I think that there is a point where you can have too many vehicles, and so you do need to be careful with that. But there are at least some vehicles that I think would make great, at least enemies, even if they're not things that you can pilot. Like, think of the Shadow from Halo 2. I forget what the Needler mech is that the Covenant have in Halo Wars. You know what I'm talking about. It's not a Scarab. Locust, that's it. I can see that being a cool enemy to fight. In terms of vehicles, I mean, the Grizzly's fine, but I don't see why you would have that and the Scorpion, because essentially they serve the same functionality. Yeah, the Grizzly's slightly more powerful, but if you're going to go that route, why even bother with the Scorpion at all? Scorpion's too classic. I don't think people are going to want to get rid of it. That's just my personal opinion. But yes, I think they should incorporate some vehicles, but be careful with what they incorporate. So I hope that answers your question, Trevelyan. Always good to see you, bro. Thank you. Our next question comes from Quantum Gaming and Stop Motion. We're just going to call him Quantum here. And Quantum asks, what is the best movie? Before you answer, it's Top Gun. You're not going to like... Okay, you might like me for this. So my dad would agree with you on that one. He loves Top Gun. He's a cop, you know. He loves military-type stuff. I think it's one of his favorite movies, if not his most favorite movie. Personally, as much as I enjoy Top Gun, my favorite movie, just to kind of sit back and watch and enjoy, is Independence Day. The original one, not that mess they came out with last year. But I love the original one. I thought it was like the perfect alien movie. You know, of course, the aliens come in, they cast these huge shadows over the Earth, they knock out the satellites, you know, they destroy everything with their big lasers. Then we try to fight back, we lose, we try to fight them with nukes, we lose, and then we... I mean, it's a convoluted plot, but it's straightforward, it's good summer fun, it's a great popcorn flick. I don't get tired of it. And so, I probably see the movie 100 times at this point. Let's kick the tires and light the fires, Big Daddy, am I right? So that's definitely my favorite movie personally. And you know what? Since we're on the subject, why don't you guys in the comments below tell me what your favorite movie is? I'd like to hear about that too. And don't say Nightfall, for the love of God. Our next question comes from Nevinger. And Nevinger asked, and by the way, he used to be apparently, he made a little notation here, Nathan Freeman. He's been in the Q&As before, so good to see you, bro. And Nevinger asked, would you be fine with Halo if it stopped making games but continued its lore and story-related aspects in books and comics? Absolutely. I mean, every series can run its course. I don't expect them to be making Halo games forever. I think that there's a lot of interesting lore out there that they can expand on. And that would also get away from the concept of they have to use all that external lore in the games, which just further confuses people. If the lore is just in the books, you can't blame it on anything else at this point. So I would be perfectly fine with that. And I think it's a great idea. Hopefully, you know what they're doing with the Reclaimer Saga. If they don't have anything else that they're planning on releasing in terms of games, maybe they could go that route. I think that's a great suggestion and one they should take. So great question, Nevinger, and thanks. And our final question of the week comes from Adele Altamimi. And Adele asks, if the Master Chief dies, who should take his place as the protagonist? So this is a bit of a loaded question here. I'm going to be straight with you. I've already said in the past that I don't want any games to be released that take place after the Reclaimer Saga, because I think the universe that they're already in is convoluted enough. They don't need any more space magic or anything like that. Just leave it as is. And if they're going to do more Halo games, make them games that take place in the past. There's tons of things that they can base these games off of. But let's say, hypothetically speaking, that they're not going to listen to anybody and they're going to continue forward anyway. There are a couple of things they could do here. The first is they could take off on the Arbiter side of things and show his war against the Covenant. And maybe even, you know, what happens afterwards, if there's any conflict after the Reclaimer Saga, follow the events of the Arbiter. There still could be different factions of Covenant in the universe, especially when you talk about Banished. You know, we still haven't seen the last of them yet. Don't know how the expansion's going to turn out later this year, but I think that that could be something that they could work off of, and the Arbiter could easily be a protagonist there. But in terms of just Spartans, just flat-out Spartans, I see two options. First is Nathan Fillion, who plays Spartan Buck. Honestly, he's probably the funniest character in the series. I mean, he kind of rivals Sergeant Johnson in that area, but he's got a great sense of humor. Everyone loves Nathan Fillion. I love Buck, more so in ODST than in Halo 5, but I could see a series based off of his journey from going from being an ODST to a Spartan. I think that would be pretty cool. But the only other Spartan out there that I think is worthy of replacing the Chief is Spartan Jerome. He was fantastic in Halo Wars 2. I don't really remember him from the original Halo Wars. I don't know if he was in it or not. But in Halo Wars 2, absolutely. He was fantastic. He's got some great lines. He seems like a very personable character, but a badass at the same time. And if someone were to replace the Chief, and I like I said, I don't think Master Chief's going to be around that much longer. But if someone were to replace the Chief, I think he would be a prime candidate. So I hope that answers your question. It was a great one indeed, Adele. And that does bring a close to this week's Q&A. And I want you guys to tell me in the comments below, who do you think would qualify to replace the Master Chief in the Halo series? You can let me know in the comments below or hit me up on Twitter, as I mentioned earlier, at Mythic Tyrant. And if you like this video and you want to see more, click that subscribe button for more great content every single day right here on MythicTyrant.com. I hope each and every one of you has an amazing weekend. I'll catch you all right back here next time. And as always, I'm the Tyrant, signing off.